Let's take a look at the Enable Features page in NetSuite. Did you know that there are 10 subtabs under Enable Features? These subtabs include over 200 unique features. Covering all these features would make for a tedious video. So instead, we'll highlight some of the key features in each of the first 5 subtabs. Keep in mind that the important thing is what each feature does, not where each feature is located. Generally, the name of each feature is self-explanatory. But if you ever can't tell what a feature does just from the name, be sure to look it up. First is the Company subtab. This section includes a variety of features that apply to the company in general. For example, it includes 3 ways to track activity: by departments, by locations, and by classes. It also includes features that relate to specific projects. 2 key features in this section include projects, which tracks projects for customers, and project management, which tracks projects for the company apart from what is going on with the customer records. The ERP general section includes features like multiple units of measure, use deletion reason, and multi-subsidiary customer. If your company has international subsidiaries, then the international section with the features multi-language, multiple currencies, currency exchange rate integration, and worldwide support for phone number formatting provides important functions for keeping the information in your subsidiaries unified. The data management section with features like inline editing, file cabinet, and duplicate detection and merge enables you to update and organize data efficiently. Next up, we have the accounting subtab, which includes 3 sections: basic features, advanced features, and multi-book accounting. The basic features are arguably the most important. Interestingly, the first of the accounting features is simply called accounting. Presumably, if this feature isn't turned on, then the other accounting features wouldn't have the information they need to work properly. This section also includes features like accounts receivable and accounts payable, as well as accounting periods and GL audit numbering. The advanced features delve into more involved aspects of accounting. If you do not regularly work with the accounting features in your NetSuite instance, then you probably won't intuitively understand what these features do just from their name. So you may want to spend some extra time reviewing those features. The tax section has only 2 features: advanced taxes and EU one-stop shop. Advanced taxes tracks taxes in your company and makes use of tax schedules. The EU one-stop shop, as NetSuite describes it, is needed for EU B2B distance sales. The transaction subtab, with nearly 40 different features listed, has the most features of any subtab. The 5 sections under transactions are basic features, sales, shipping and receiving, billing, and payment processing. Most of the basic features include create and track functions. For example, sales orders create and track customer sales orders, purchase orders create and track purchase orders, and requisitions create and track requisitions. Sales includes things like multiple prices, supporting multiple prices for a single item, gross profit, tracking the gross profit on items, and promotion codes, enabling customers to use coupons. Some features in the other 3 sections include things like advanced shipping, shipping label integration, advanced receiving, advanced billing, credit card payments, and electronic funds transfer. Items and inventory, as the name suggests, has only 2 sections: items and inventory. One of the key features is inventory. If you plan for NetSuite to track your inventory at all, enabling this feature would be a good place to start. This feature includes anything in your inventory, whether those items are finished goods or parts. Some other key features include multi-location inventory, lot tracking, bin management, demand planning, and inventory count. Studying all the available features under Enable Features can be overwhelming, but keeping the end goal in mind will help. On the actual SuiteFoundation exam, only a couple questions will deal directly with what specific features do. So as you study, don't get too bogged down in the details. Try to connect the names of the features to their functions as much as possible, which will make remembering specific functions less tedious and more intuitive. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.